48 hours, Bryant. Then I'm coming looking for that wee girl of yours.
Bryant, 48 hours. Oh, one more thing, Mr. Ross. Can I trust you to do something for me without Inspector Grace knowing about it?
Sure, there's no love lost between Grace and me.
This letter is very important. See, it gets to the person it's addressed to without Grace getting his hands on it, will you?
Wait till Grace gets a load of this. He's going to think he's won the lottery.
Hey, Bev, hop on the dryers, let Kate work there, will you? Can you take over on the press a minute, Lil? How'd your visit go?
Fine.
Had no trouble passing that note?
No, none.
Any questions asked?
Of course not. What are mothers for if you can't rely on them?
You reckon it'll get there all right?
Yes, she knows about the censorship. I told you it was to your boyfriend.
Oh, Struth, Jenny McCauley, I'd have to be hard up. He'd slit your throat as soon as look at you. Anyway, thanks, Doc. I won't forget this once I get things going around here again. I never forget a favour.
Hello.
Happy hunter home from the hill.
Oh, Mum, where on earth have you been? I was starting to get worried.
Oh, I just realised that you and Jeff were leaving tonight without a proper send-off. I got a few things for a celebration. Where is Jeff?
Oh, you have to go and get some milk. I'm making coffee. Would you like some?
Coffee? Who needs coffee when the champagne's on the house?
Mum, not again.
Well, they ran out of the expensive stuff. This is cooking champagne.
Ah, you're back.
Hello.
You okay?
Of course I am. What is all this?
Ah, just when you left, you seemed a bit worried about something, that's all.
Oh, it was just the old saying, all good things must come to an end. I think it got to me a bit.
Listen, why don't I stay on for a couple of extra days? Then I can go and meet Jeff up at Archer's and we'll go back to Queensland from there.
Listen, you two, I am perfectly all right. I am capable of looking after myself. I mean, you set me up with a family and a home and a job. Don't worry about me. Anyway, we'll have plenty of chances to see each other. When my parole comes through, I might even move to Queensland and get a job up there. Although they tell me the drivers are pretty hairy.
Are you sure, Mum?
That's certain.
I don't want to leave you, you know that.
This is supposed to be a party, for crying out loud. Will you open that champagne? There's plenty of food there. Have a real party, huh?
Great.
Just like my 21st day, except with one more person.
Yeah, it was better surroundings too, huh? Oh, it's more like it.
There you are.
Thank you.
Here we go.
Oh. Nothing like a bit of spumanti, huh?
I reckon this printing press like should be a real hoot, don't you, Biff?
Now, I know why you're so keen. You fancy this Marnie bloke, right?
Oh, yeah, sure. Oh, I don't reckon I stand much of a chance. He seems to have an eye for Mrs. Morris.
Oh, not only her. I've seen the way he's been looking at Po-Face, pal. I reckon he gets off on uniform.
Oh, he's probably into leather and whips, too. Should do well here.
Oh, yeah. Shut up, Smith, or you'll be on extra duties.
Well, I'd like to oblige Mrs. Powell, but I'm a sick woman. I've just undergone major surgery.
Well, in that case, you'd be better off confined to your cell until you're really well. As for Mr. Marnie, I doubt whether he'll be here long enough to act out your fantasies for you. You lot will muck up this project, just like you've mucked up everything else in the past.
Would you type up these reports for Mrs. Davidson, please, Julie?
Okay.
Mrs. Morris, I'm sorry if I embarrassed you. I should have realised with the women there.
Oh, that's all right, Mr. Marnie. I've had this job for some time. I don't embarrass easily.
Good. I didn't want to start off on the wrong foot. I think it should prove quite popular, don't you?
Yes. You're still on duty.
Yep, just coming up for round two.
The double shift. Wear yourself out. Have you met Mr. Marnie, the printing instructor?
No, hi.
Pleased to meet you. Hello, Mr. Douglas.
Oh, good afternoon, Mr. Marnie. Fawkner?
Well, now, how's the press coming along? Will you have it operational soon?
I'll tell the governor you're here, sir.
That's not necessary.
Well, we seem to be getting it set up very well. The women seem keen on learning. I don't think it'll take long at all for them to latch on to the basics.
Ah, good, good. Well, keep in touch. We'd like to get it into production as soon as possible.
Up, two, three. Where did Mrs. Morris get to?
Oh, she just rushed off.
He probably wanted to get away from me. I'm afraid I made a bit of a faux pas in the workroom yesterday. Made us both look a bit silly in front of the prisoners.
Well, as you know, the government has been forced to cut back on its spending, find more economical ways of running its business. Thank you. And that's where your press comes in.
What sort of work will we be doing, Mr. Douglas?
Oh, letterheads, that sort of thing. More complex paperwork will be looked after by the government printer. At any rate, the sooner you get going, the better.
Well, of course, that will depend on how quickly the women learn.
Well, naturally. I've spoken to Mr. Marnie. He seems to think they're all keen.
At the moment.
Sorry?
Well, they are always eager to start something new. They're not very good at keeping up the enthusiasm.
I'm sure they'll get every encouragement from the officers. And I need hardly remind you, the production must be strictly policed. We can't have them wallpapering their cells with government paper. Yes, well, I think that's all I have to say. Was there anything else, Mrs. Davidson?
Well, yes, there was the matter raised by Mrs. Morris.
Oh, what was that?
Oh, it's about the guard dogs, sir. They seem very savage.
They're not supposed to be family pets, Mrs. Morris. And the union did agree to them.
Yes, I realize that. Not even the officers can go near them. We were wondering whether the handler could be transferred here full time.
I'll look into the possibility of an exchange. I can't afford to take an experienced officer from Pentridge, but I want it understood. The department will not back down on this. Those dogs are here to stay.
You know, if Myra can improve the standard of Tucker in this place, I'll be pleased to see her at the top.
I do hope you're joking.
How about a cup of tea to take away the taste?
Oh, what a good idea.
Sandy? Did you ever hear any more from the police about Megan Arnott?
Well, old Grace. Gosh, no, he wouldn't know his bum from his ear hole. If he only knew.
Knew what?
Oh, about 6 miles out of Wedderburn, there's this old shack on a property that used to belong to a racehorse owner or something like that. If he knew what was under the floorboards, he'd be on his way to his next promotion and I'd be doing another 20 years.
Well, what is it?
Oh, Megan's wallet. And what is technically known as the murder weapon, with my dabs all over it.
Good grief, you're taking a risk, aren't you?
Well, he'll never find out, will he?
Hey, Kate, run down to the rec room for us, will you, love? Make sure that Mari isn't throwing her weight round. If I go down there, I'll drop the bitch.
Will I.
Well, all right. But what about the tea?
Oh, don't worry, I'll fix it. So, are you crazy? You said yourself you didn't trust her. Fancy letting that lot slip in front of her.
I don't trust her an inch. Wouldn't be at all surprised to find out she's our lader. That's why I fed her all that bull dust. If she is lagging, someone's going to be very upset with her. Very upset indeed.
Hey, listen, Hayes. I know you don't mind the occasional joint, so how come you're back in Smith? If she's in charge here, that's the last you'll see of any dope in this place.
Yeah, I know. But B's not the sort of person you can just forget about, especially with Sandy beside her.
Well, neither am I, sweetheart, and I don't need anyone backing me. Just you keep that in mind. I'm getting some more goodies in soon, and I look after me mates.
All right, ladies, back to cells, please.
You going to come and tuck me in, Mr. Fawkner?
No, Lizzie, you're a big girl now.
Oh, yeah, I know, but I'm still scared of the dark. I mean, well, the bogeyman might get me, with any luck.
Go on, Peterson.
I'm coming.
Go on, what'd you say, Mr. Fawkner? It gets pretty lonely in this cell.
Come on, keep moving, Winter.
Fair sucker, the salve. Why should Edwards be the only one?
I said keep moving.
Hurry up, Peterson. You heard the bell. I'm coming. There's no need to shout.
Just a minute. Don't you talk to me like that.
Trouble, Mrs. Powell?
No. It's all right. I'll deal with it. Thanks, Mr. Fawkner. Got some information for me?
No, but I need another visit from Inspector Grace.
Here we go, that same old boring cry. Why the hell should I bother setting it up for you? You haven't given me anything for ages.
Please, Mrs. Powell, one or two of the women are getting very suspicious and I need to lie low for a while.
In that case, we'd best postpone a visit until the heat's off you.
I can't. I have to see him as soon as possible. Look, Mrs. Powell, I've given you a lot of information in the past and there'll be more. But I must see Grace.
Get back to your cell. I'll think about it.
Have to be going soon, Mum.
I know, love.
Thanks for the party.
Well, next time we'll see you have a proper party. French champagne, a million people.
It'll be soon, too, okay?
Yeah. Packed and ready to go.
All set, then.
All right.
Now, you got Uncle Archie's address. I expect to see you on the weekend. It's only a short drive.
Oh, we'll see.
Oh, please, Mum, we'd really like you to.
Listen, you two, I spend all week driving a car. You don't think I want to do the same thing on the weekend, do you? Of course, I'll come.
Well, Mum, it's been great.
I feel the same way, Jeff. Bye-bye.
See you.
And you look after yourself. Drive carefully, huh?
Will do. See you on the weekend.
Got yourself a nice fella there, haven't you?
Mm, I know. Now, what about you? Are you sure you're going to be okay?
Of course. Will you stop worrying?
Oh, bugger it. Hi. Just having a last-minute cigarette. Do you want to come in?
No. Mrs. Powell's in the East Wing. She could be back at any time.
Fair enough.
You're pretty good at using people, aren't you?
Hey, what are you talking about?
You set me up to help you get that Fitzwater bloke in here, taking that letter out for you.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry about that. I won't lag on you if that's what you're worried about.
It makes me an accessory.
To what? It wasn't murder. It was self-defense. Fletch said that, and the cops are happy.
Yeah. He must have been a real bastard.
He had my husband killed. You don't muck around with people like that. It's all or nothing. Look, I'm sorry, but I had to use you. There was no other way I had of getting him to come in here. I'm not going to be backed into a corner by anyone, especially McNally's mob. You give them one inch and they'll push you all the way.
Won't the rest of the mob be after you now?
I doubt it. There's no profit in killing me. Anyway, I'll cross that bridge when I come to it.
Quite a little tigress, aren't you?
In this jungle, that's the only thing to be.
Seeing as how your daughter's gone away now.
Well, they've gone to the movies, haven't they? They'll be back any minute.
Is that a fact? Funny they took all the luggage with them, aren't they? Eh? I'd say they'd gone to Archie's for a couple of days, wouldn't you? See, I know Archie quite well. Had a long chat with him on the phone just the other day.
It's just... You bastard!
Yeah, no, you don't, Bryant.
Kill you!
Remind me of the time you tried to stick me with a knife, eh? You didn't do too well then, huh? Then you got blamed. Hey! Come on, try it! You bloody mess!
Oh, my God!
Try it! Try it!
Oh, my God!
Let's just see what you learned in that massage palace, eh? You put up a good struggle, Lassie. I like that in a woman. Gets the old blood rushing through the veins again. I'll be over tomorrow to get that money. Maybe you can, be nice to old Jock again, eh? Don't get any ideas of double-cross me, Brian. Because if you do, I might just pay a wee visit to, what's her name again? Laurie. That's right, Laurie. Just to see if she's as good as her mother. I'll see you real soon.
Relief column. Thank God you made it. General Kitchener, the men are nearly dead with exhaustion.
What a pity. They'll be too tired to carry home their pay packets.
Don't you believe it. The human body can endure a lot.
You're amazingly bright for somebody who's just spent 16 hours on the job.
Oh, I guess I'm just settling in a bit more. It doesn't seem so much like work now. I thought about what you told me, you know, about not just treating it like a job.
Good. Well, it does help if you care a little about the women, rather than simply lock them up and forget about them.
Good morning. Mrs. Morris, Mr. Fawkner.
Morning.
You're back again, then. The women couldn't have given you too hard a time yesterday.
No, I think I can cope.
Oh, by the way, Mrs. Davidson would like to see you before you start work.
Right.
Well, see you all later.
Oh, Mrs. Morris, I was wondering if we could have a little chat about the women working on the project. It would help me to know who I'm working with.
Yes, yes, I suppose it would, but I'm sorry I haven't the time to sit and chat today. Things are a bit hectic. Oh,
of course. How about after work?
No, I'm afraid not.
I assure you, it's strictly business. Now, I noticed there was a pub just down the road. Couldn't we meet there and have a run out on the women? It would only take 20 minutes.
All right, then. But just 20 minutes.
There she stands, Officer Powell, eagerly awaiting the arrival of the handsome printer who'll sweep her off her feet.
Okay, sweetheart. Come with me to the Casbah. I'll give you all the print you can handle.
Haven't you lot got something you can do until he gets here?
Oh, we'd better not, Mrs. Powell. We might muck it up without Mr. Marnie.
Someone should tell him about the importance of prison routine.
Oh, I'm sure you will, Mrs. Powell.
Right. Doesn't look as though he's coming, so the lesson's cancelled. Oh. Smith, Edwards, you will report back to the laundry.
Now, fair go, Mrs. Powell. He's only 10 minutes late. Maybe he had a flat tire or got held up or something.
Well, I'm not holding up prison work because of him. Kent, Dobbs, you will report to C block for cleaning.
Oh, geez, are we pleased to see you.
Yay! Nice to know I'm wanted.
Yes, you were wanted, Mr. Marnie, a quarter of an hour ago.
10 minutes.
I was about to move the women onto other duties. In the future, would it be too much to ask you to be punctual?
I'm sorry, I got held up.
I told you.
Mrs. Davidson wanted to talk to me.
Would it be nice of you to let us know? Start the lesson, please, immediately. I have other duties to attend to, but I will be back shortly.
God, Davo's for it now.
Yeah, the cheek of the governor keeping Mrs. Power waiting.
Well, all right, ladies. Let's get down to work, shall we?
There should be a new paragraph here, shouldn't it? And this bit done in capitals?
Okay.
All right? Good. Thanks, Judy. Judy, what on earth are you doing here? Leave something in yourself.
Now, how are you, Mrs. Morris? Look, I was wondering, could I possibly see Doreen?
Is everything all right? I mean, is the job okay?
Oh, everything's fine. Everything's good. The job's going really well. Not used to the long hours yet, though.
Well, it's against regulations, you know that.
Yeah, I know. Do you think maybe Mrs. Davidson could bend the rules a little bit this time? I mean, Laurie's gone back to Queensland. I'm just feeling a bit lonely, that's all.
Yes, well, I'll go and ask her. You sit down over there.
So, although you're keeping it clean, you always oil that before you use it, don't you?
every day, Virgil. Be back in a minute.
Thank you. How's it going?
Tedious. It's a bit hard to tell some of these apart.
Yeah, I think you'll find most of that box is Roman, but you might find some Gothic ones in there as well. You've got quite a few to sort out there. I'll get someone else to give you a hand, okay?
Okay. Thanks.
Just give a hand to them, some of those locks.
Well, congratulations. You've just landed yourself a bummer of a job.
I don't mind. Sandy, I guess you're really going to get married, aren't you?
You better believe it.
What about the people who are on her side?
If they get in the way, they'll get flattened.
Mary's a pretty tough lady. She sort of leans on people.
Hayes, are you trying to tell me something?
Yeah, well, sort of. It's just that Murray'd be so mad if she knew.
Murray won't hurt you, I'll make sure of that.
Well, a couple of days before your old man was killed, Murray got a letter in the laundry bag. Now, I don't know what was in it, but it was addressed to you.
Is that so? So that's what Jack meant.
How do you mean?
Jack Fitzwater told me that my husband was killed to teach me a lesson. Obviously, there was something in that letter that they wanted me to do, but I didn't get it thanks to that white-haired bitch.
You're not going to tell her I told you, are
you? Don't you worry. Murray Winter's got a lot to answer for, and by bloody hell, I'm going to make her pay.
Gone so well for you, Jude, but I bet you miss Laurie, eh?
Yeah, I sure do. Still, work's keeping me pretty busy, you know. I'd forgotten how tiring it was sitting in a taxi all day. How about you, love? Women still giving you a hard time?
Oh, they pretty much leave me on my own now. You know, it suits me.
Yeah, it's good. Well, your arm bothering you much?
Oh, no, not now.
Listen, Doreen, I want you to keep smiling and don't talk too loud. I need a favour.
Oh, sure, Jude. What is it?
Well, I should have asked to see Sandy, but they would have never let me in to see her.
Oh, what's up?
Sandy's the only one that can get me what I want under the counter.
Well, what is it?
It's a handgun. Small one, something I can hide easily.
Is this a gag?
No, it's not a gag, Doreen. I'm dead serious. Will you keep smiling?
That's a real good one, Jude.
What's happened? Chuck Stewart's turned up.
How did you run into him?
Look, he said he wants $5,000. If I don't give it to him, he's going to see that Laurie has an accident. Now, I've got to do this. I'll never get him off my back otherwise.
But you can't, Jude. It's murder. Why don't you go to the police and get those mongrels to earn their money for
it? No! I've got to get this bastard after what he's done to me, Dora.
Done any good printing yet?
Oh, yeah. We've got a whole porno novel ready to be published.
We haven't done nothing yet. Sort out boxes of type. Yeah.
Well, it's still better than mopping corridor floors.
Just hurry up with your lunch, please, Doreen.
Mr. Screw's tame dog. Come off it. Hayes, you ought to be more charitable. You know what it says in the Bible. Let him who is without sin chuck the first rock.
And what about our commandment, thou shalt not lay? Oh, look, I think I'll go and read until the bell goes.
Yeah, I'm due for a cuppa.
Let him get you down, Dora. I'm still your mate.
Yeah. Listen, Lizzie, I've just had a visit from Judy.
Beauty, how is she?
Well, I'm real worried about her. That Jock Stewart's turned up again. He's got real demanding and heavy. You know what she wants me to do? She wants me to get her a gun from Sandy.
God, you mean she's gonna bump him off? She can't do that.
Well, I know that, but I can't let her down and she won't go to the police.
It's truth. I know.
Well, do you think I should tell somebody?
You mean Lag? Oh, well, it's lagging and lagging. And I suppose if you're doing it for somebody to protect them from themselves, well, there is some excuse for it.
You reckon?
Of course. Stands to reason.
Well, I reckon I should have a word to Mrs. Morris.
You wanted to see me, Doreen?
Yeah, I have to talk to you, Mrs. M. It's real important.
Hello?
Well, you know the time I asked you not to say anything about Peter and me?
Yes, and you know the trouble I got into because of it. Don't ask me to do it again.
Yeah, well, this is about Judy.
Yes, I thought it might be.
She's in real trouble, Mrs. M, and she wants me to help her. But I didn't want to make things worse for her, and I didn't want to lag on her either.
All right, now just calm down and tell me properly.
Well, it's about that Jock Stewart who used to work here. He's turned up again, and he's demanding money from her and getting heavy and everything.
What's he doing? Blackmailing her? Threats of violence?
Hey, did you hear about Fido?
Who?
Doreen the dog. Lizzie just told us she lagged on Jude.
What about?
Well, Jude wanted a gun, and she asked Dore to ask you where to get one.
What for?
She wants to knock off a screw.
Hmm. Well, there's millions of places. I can't see her getting away with it.
He's a real bastard, that Jock Stewart. I reckon good on her if she wants to have a go. Trust Dore to lag, but...
Yeah.
Sandy, me telling you about that letter that Mari got, well, that's not really lagging, is it?
No, that's being sensible. You should have told me when it happened, though.
Yeah, I know, but she made me swear not to.
Mari's time's running out fast.
Are you going to fix her?
I've got a little plan for when we're next together in the laundry.
Now, what the hell are you two doing here? The bell's gone. Get to work.
Sorry, Miss Conway, we didn't notice it. You know what it's like in here.
I don't think she can remember back that far, hey? Get going.
Just going.
Hello, Dor. Did you tell Mrs. M?
Yeah. She said she'd go and speak to Jude, but I'm still not sure I've done the right thing.
Of course you have. Like I told the others, it's not really lagging.
You told the others?
Yeah. I wanted them to get the story straight. Otherwise, they might have thought you was lagging.
Oh, well, that's terrific. Thanks a lot, Lizzie. I mean, they're crook enough on me as it is. Now, no bugger will want anything to do with me.
That's not true. B and me are still your mates. The other women are only a bit sour on you because you lagged to old vinegar tits at Barnhurst. They'll get over it.
Yeah, sure. And Mouse will get to be Prime Minister.
Oh, come on. It'll all work out. You'll see.
I'm going out to the garden to speak to the dogs. At least they like me.
Who is it?
It's Meg Morris, Judy.
Hello, Mrs. Morris. What are you doing here?
It's about Jock Stewart.
I suppose Doreen told you.
Yes, she did. God. Well, she only did it because she's worried about you. You put her in a very awkward position.
Yeah, I suppose so.
It took a lot of courage for Doreen to speak to me, especially with the way the women are treating her at the moment.
Are you planning on bringing in the police?
I think it's the best way, don't you?
I don't. I don't want them involved in this.
Look, I could report it myself.
I'll deny it.
Judy, why don't you tell me the whole story? And then perhaps you'll be interested in an idea that I've got.
That'll be him.
Now just calm down. You sure you can carry it off?
Yeah.
Just take it easy. I'll be right in there.
Ah. Fit of the security chain. Good idea, Lassie. Keeps our unwanted guests, eh? And you're gonna offer me a drink?
Help yourself. You will anyway.
Can't see. Was Archie angry when you asked him for the money?
How?
I didn't think he would be. I mean, $5,000 is just a drop in the ocean to him, and you're practically family now.
He wasn't angry because I didn't ask him.
You're getting it from somewhere else, eh?
I can't get that kind of money. I need more time.
You've got plenty of time, Lassie. I'm a pretty patient man. But I'm starting to get a wee bit irritable now.
How many times do I have to tell you can't blackmail me? Laurie and Jeff know everything.
Many times have I had to tell you, if you don't get that money, lovely Laurie is going to meet with a nasty accident.
She's in Queensland. You can't touch her.
You must think I'm a real fool, Brian. You know how long it took me to find out your address that day after the trust, don't you? Wouldn't take me more than about, 10 minutes to find out her address in Queensland. Might even be worth the trip up there. She's quite a spunky-looking little lady.
You bastard!
Did I get that money? I'll do a pay visit to that wee daughter of yours. Hey?
Hi there, Mrs. Stewart.
What's this? Hidden witnesses? You're getting devious, Brian. Very devious.
I suggest you leave this place now and never come back. The police will be very interested in what I just overheard.
You must be a very brave woman, Mrs. Morris. Because I know you're not a fool. I could get rid of the two of you right here and now. No one would be any the wiser.
You don't think I'd be stupid enough not to let anyone know where I am or who I'm with? Police will pick you up in a couple of hours.
You're bluffing.
Pentridge must have been a breeze for you last time. Locked in isolation, away from all the other prisoners who hated you. I wonder what sort of treatment you'll get next time when they find out you've killed a fellow prison officer. I think you've seen the last of him.
I hope so.
If you want to make certain, we'll call the police.
No. Laurie and Jeff, I don't want them going through all this. Lots of her friends in Queensland know I'm her mother. I don't want it to hit the newspapers.
Oh, watch it!
Hey, what's up with you, Lizzie? You look like you're mad at something.
Too bloody right I am. I want a word with you.
Okay. What's all this about?
It's about Dore, that's what. How long are you going to keep her in Coventry?
Oh, come on.
She's done her punishment. Now, when are you going to call it quits?
Not just me. All the women are crook on her.
They'll all listen to you if you tell them to pack it in.
She is a lagger.
God, she had to lag on Jude for her own good.
And what about Barnhurst?
She only lagged on Mari's friends at Barnhurst. God, you ought to be patting her on the back instead of pounding her. You're a bloody hypocrite.
Think about it.
Well, you better think about it bloody quick or else
Or else what?
Or else I'll bring you down a peg or two, that's what.
Oh, nothing. I was just looking for Mari and the others, Miss Conway.
Oh, they've gone down to the loading bay to get the printing paper. Now, what do you want?
Well, really, I was looking for an officer to take me through to the garden.
Have you got permission?
Yeah, Mrs. Davidson said I could work out there any time I liked.
All right, I'll take you through. Come on. Right, there you go. And keep away from the dogs. The way they bark, they drive anyone mad.
dining room, but you'll have to wait for him, okay? Better than that awful tin stuff they give you, isn't it? Hey? Yeah, come to think of it, you probably get even better stuff than we do. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get out of this dump. That's what I'm gonna do. Because they all hate being here. And you know, even Lizzie, she can't let a person forget a mistake. Yeah, that's all. You two let me know if anybody comes, okay? Oh, you're real good mates, you two are. Huh? That mob of bitches in there. Who needs them? You know, Judy used to be one of my best friends, but I can't go and see her. Because it'll stuff up her parole. I've got no mates in Barnhurst and no friends here. So what's the point in sticking around?
Mrs. Morris?
I had everything. A car, plenty of money, good clothes. Now I've got nothing.
What did you expect me to do? Keep working in that lousy massage parlor just to line your pockets?
I know. Better than rotting in a cell,
yeah,
huh?
Bet on it.
You know, the trouble with you, Brian, is... Your trouble is that you get too many Victorian models. Now, a dyke like you... can't afford to know what
I'm surprised you'd even know what they are.
I found they get in my way. Another one of your troubles, Brian, is you make too many mistakes. I'm getting that Meg Morris here. Now that was a real bad blue. You know what I mean?
Boys, how are you? Hey? Oh, I'd really like to take you two with me, but I don't think I'd get very far with you two tagging along. Do you think so? I'm real sorry, fellas. Okay? You wait here.
Hmm.
Have you told him yet?
No, I was waiting for you so you could hear the announcement. Okay, you lot, listen up. Right. From now on, Doreen's to be treated normally. No more ignoring her or pushing around.
It's true. Who says so?
I do.
Well, Mari won't like it. She reckons Dore didn't get what was coming to her for lagging.
I don't give a damn what Mari won't like. She's only crooked on Doreen because it was her thick mates at Barnhurst that copped it. They were pushing their weight around and pushed Doreen just a bit too far. Well, I say all this sending her to Coventry's got to stop, and anyone who doesn't agree can argue the toss with me personally.
And anyone that Sandy forgets, I'll fix them.
Any takers?
Oh, fair enough. Dore's all right, even if she is a lagger.
By now, I suppose you're wondering what I'm going to do to you, Brian. I'm going to hurt you. I'm going to hurt you real bad. Just to teach you a lesson. Of course, now that Meg Morris has stuck her nose in, I have to shoot through after I've done it. Because she'll inform the police as soon as she finds out where you are. I think Queensland might be a nice place to go to. It's nice at this time of the year. Plenty of sunshine. Lots of women. I might even look up little Laurie for you, eh? You'd appreciate that. Well, you're recovering in hospital, wouldn't you, eh? Getting a letter from Laurie, saying how she'd run into your old friend, Jock Stewart.
You evil bastard! You'll never hurt Laurie, you evil bastard! I'll kill you, son of a bitch! I'll never make a man of you!
You make too many bloody mistakes!
For God's sake, Bride, please help me.
Please, I can't move.
Sharon couldn't move either. You remember Sharon, Jock? Because I do. Well, this one's for Sharon. And Dore. And me. And all the women that you've bashed and hurt.
Please. At least call an ambulance, please. I can't move. Oh, please, I can't move. Oh, please, please. Oh, please, Brian. Please, I can't move. Please.
Oh, this is a hard one, Amber. This is much harder. Now, come on, boys. You can't come with me. Come on, you go back to the other fence. Go back. Go back. Go, Emma. Go back.
But that was on the outside.
and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.